First of all, let's have a look on Hyperion website. So here we see that AmigaOS 3.2.1 update is available since 2 days ago, 3 days ago. And everyone who is who bought AmigaOS 3.2, they have a serial number which they use to register their copy at the website. And as soon as they do that, they are going to be able to download the LHA archive with the update, which I have already here. And of course, to register your copy, your serial number of the AmigaOS 3.2, you have to log in at the website of Hyperion, register your copy, and get the download. So I'm going to do the update on the emulated AmigaOS 3.2 that I have shown you before. I have here a folder where I have the AmigaOS 3.2. I have here a hard disk file with the installation. Let me start it. And let me do that full screen. So right now you see the screen is a little bit stretched because of my scaler. Actually, on AmigaOS 4, the resolution is 640 to 512, which is 4:3 ratio. And it shows pretty fine, but because of my scaler that I have here, you see that stretched. So I have here the installation of AmigaOS 3.2, and SLT Snake says, I was earlier updating my Amithlon Sys and the ROM file. Okay, it works fine there with Amithlon, or did you have any issues? So what I have to do here is, here I have a shared folder with the rest of the AmigaOS 4, and I have the update here, which I can't double click because I don't have a default application, but I will open a shell and do LHAX. Drag and drop the AmigaOS 3.2.1 update and point it to RAM. Everything fine, eh? Hello, Livelord. Welcome to the stream. Thank you very much for joining. We are going to see the update, the Christmas gift that Hyperion and the developers of AmigaOS 3.2 gave us just a few days before Christmas. And since it is Christmas Eve today, we are going to have a special stream, different from the rest, from the previous ones. We are going to see the update for AmigaOS 3.2, and then we are going to have some Christmas games. So I extracted the update. We have here a folder in RAM, and let me see information. Yeah, the update is around 32 megabytes of files. Okay, so plenty of things changed. There is some information here how to install it, but we are going to see all the steps right now, and a summary of all the changes. We are going to have a look on a few of them, and let's start the update. The first thing that you need to do is go to ADFs, and mount the update 3.2.1 ADF file, the image for the disk. Click install, select the installer based on your language. For the Greek, don't worry, you are not going to have any problems, because although it's for Greek, all the texts are in English. This the installer was not translated. Yeah, Live Alert, it's about 3.2.1, but running on AmigaOS 4, because we are going to see different things today. Yeah, it was a beautiful present, Live Alert, you're right. And to be honest, I didn't expect it to be released so soon. I had that because I'm a beta tester and translator for the Greek language. So I was following the update and the new things that were coming. Let's continue the installation, proceed. Update 3.2.1 will now be installed on your hard drive. Okay, any previous release will be replaced. Do you want update 3.2.1 installed? Yes. Here, if you don't want for that to be installed in that partition, you have to click on no, and then the installer is going to ask you exactly for which partition it's going to use and where to install the update. For me, it's fine because I have only one partition here, so it is quite well. Yes, I will choose Greek as well. So the new update is going to update the startup sequence. The startup sequence, we have discussed about that file before. It's the first script that is executed when you start, when you boot your AmigaOS. So because it does some changes there and creates a new startup sequence, it stores the previous one in a folder named old under your partition, your installation partition. That's where you can find it in case you have some issues. For example, if you have hardware like fast data or something else that needs to install specific devices there, you have to go to the previous file and see what changes, what you need to load by default, so that you are not going to have issues with your installation. So I'm going to click move. It's recommended to keep that copy, because in case you have issues, you can find what you had on your previous, before the update. So right now it goes with installation. As you can see at the left side, it mounts automatically all the needed ADF files, the ADF image files for the floppies. So you don't have to do it manually. Okay, and you can relax, drink some tea or coffee. Please identify your hardware module. For me, it's a 1200. The installation of update 3.2.1 is now complete. We have to reboot. Have in mind, in this installation, there are some new ROMs, which you can use to, if you run your Amiga on an emulated environment, like me right now, I can easily use the new version of the ROM, right? On the classic hardware, you can contact your reseller if he is going to sell newer versions, although that the developers do not recommend to do that. And if it is possible to use the new ROMs with a kick ROM, based on if your hardware supports it, it is better to go that way. Because for the next versions, they say that they probably are going to make even more changes on the ROM, so they are going to release a newer version, so you don't have to buy new ROM modules all the time. SLD Snake says, I have some patches at the startup sequence, so I needed to manually edit after installation. Yes. The level says the same here for fast data. Exactly. So if, because I read somewhere on forums, I think that people with fast data had issues that they didn't accept, or the second IDE didn't work. That's the reason. You need to check again the startup sequence if it has everything in there as it, the previous one had. Level Lord says, wondering how the existing patches will work with this update, like AlphaOS, Birdie and similar. We can investigate it further if you want on the next stream. We can do that. If you remember, I have an installation with all this stuff. I know that applications that were looking for the execute command in C, if you remember, one of the WSD load launcher that we used before in one of my older streams was looking for that file, and it was not working well with AmigaOS 3.2. Now the execute is under C folder, so this is something that will make all these applications work. I haven't heard, but I didn't try that yet, any issues with the AlphaOS and the Birdie, the things that we used before to make our AmigaOS 3.2 look better on RTG systems. But we can have a look on that if you want. So let me proceed with the reset. And since it is emulated Amiga, I don't have to remove any floppy. Let's see how this goes about. So I still have the old ROM, the 3.2, and the release is 3.2.1. Let's have a look on a few updates and changes that they introduced with this update, right? Livelo says, all I can say is we'll wait on next time. Thank you, George. Thank you, Livelo, for being so loyal to my streams. Thank you very much for being here. My beloved, new feature. You know from the new version of AmigaOS 3.2 that when you have a shell, right, you can drag and drop anything you want into the shell. You will see here that you probably saw that already, that as soon as I dragged and dropped something in there, let's say this one, the shell remains active. This is so crucial, because if you are doing something, especially when you extract files with LHAX something, and then you lose the focus from the shell, it is crucial, because you have to reach your mouse again and click on the window. Right now we can do exactly drag and drop the archive there, sorry, like that, and the shell remains active. For me, it's one of the most useful changes. It seems little, small change, but it is pretty useful. One of the other changes that I would like to show you is the show config. If you remember, the show config since AmigaOS 3.2 changed, and it has its own window. And right now, it doesn't only show you some information, some basic information about the hardware, but also it shows you the devices that are mounted, the libraries that are already loaded, the resources that are occupied. So you can have a full idea of what is running on your computer right now, and find everything that might break something on your system. For example, you can have a look here, the console device, which version it is exactly. So if you have some issues and you want to know if you loaded the right console device, this is the place to go. Or the amount of memory that your computer has. And if it is fast memory, fast RAM or anything else. Residents, devices and libraries that are stored, that are loaded as residents on your system, and they remain in RAM. And yeah, the resources and the drives that are loaded, okay, and the device that they are using. And also here you can find a new menu item that is for generating a report about your hardware. There are two formats that you can export this report: Amiga Guide and text. I will select Amiga Guide for the test, and we'll save it in RAM. Sorry, in RAM here, and let's say report.amigaguide or guide. Much better. Okay, generate. You can select here which components you want to include in this report. Generate. Report has been written. Okay, let me close that and let's have a look on that. So all files, report guide. And here we have the report for our hardware in an Amiga guide file, which you can share with anyone you would like to share it with. It is useful, especially if you reporting a bug that you might found on the hardware or on the software, on the Amiga OS or something else, and the developer asks you for the hardware, what type of hardware you have, what you're running, and things like that. SLD Snake says, oh, I missed that export option when I upgraded the system. Yeah. It is quite useful, and you can also do that from the cell if you want. Exporting to Amiga Guide. It is a perfect Amiga Guide with all the information there. So if something is not working for you, hello, Creevy, welcome to the stream. If something doesn't work for you, for example, let's say that you try to run a game and it doesn't work because some library is missing or anything, and the developer says, what are you running on your system? What kind of system you have? And things like that. And you can send something like this Amiga guide with all the information. It doesn't have any personal information, so if you worry about that, so it's not something that people are going to use to track you. Libero says, that's nice, exporting to Amiga Guide. I have read about the future and it looks awesome. Yeah, exactly. Only thing regarding the Amiga Guide is that you can't search for text, or I am not aware how. The find is not enabled. Because we loaded that from MultiView, yeah, you can search, that's right. But what you can do is go to text edit, open the Amiga guide file, which is a text file, right, and search here for anything you want. like that. So you can find something here. If the Amiga guide is big, for example, the help Amiga guide of AmigaOS 3.2 is quite big. So if you try to find something, I always do this thing, because a guide file is just a plain text with a good way to look with some let's say tag text that help the Amiga guide to be shown the way it is. Libero says, I just wish there is a feature within Amiga guide. I think it's not a thing of the Amiga guide, the defined. It has to do with the viewer of that you use. I believe there were other viewers that you have the ability to search for something in the Amiga guide page, but I'm not sure which one. I'm going to look about that and let you know. So TextEdit also had a lot of bug fixes, and also they introduced another export to TextEdit. So it has an R export for every opened file that you might have. So with Rx, if you use Rx, you can talk to the TextEdit program, and especially on specific files that are open, and do stuff. Livelo says, I'll check the other viewers. Thanks. You're welcome. I will check that as well, and we can share the knowledge on the next stream. What else? Icon Edit got a big upgrade where you can. There were a few new features here, and also bug fixes. You can see that. You can have a lot of colors where you can use, which you can use to draw your icons. Okay, and you can zoom as well if you want to create icons with Icon Edit. Another cool feature is the eject. If you go here at the top of the menu, it is great right now, but it says eject disk. Let's see how it works. If we open here, let me create a new cell. Great. LHAX. To RAM. Okay, let's extract that, because it has a few ADF files in there, a lot of ADF files actually. So if you mount an ADF, like let's say this one, okay, and this one, so I have two mounted ADF files here, and you want to remove them. If you remember, with AmigaOS 3.2, you have to use the DA control and unmount these two mounted images of the floppies. So right now with the update, after the update, you can select them and go here and eject those disks like that, and they are going to be removed. And also with this inject, if you have a CD-ROM attached to your Amiga, probably it will be supported. It depends on the CD-ROM and how it communicates with the Amiga of your Amiga. And when you select the icon of the CD and click on inject, it's going to open the tray and spits out the CD-ROM. That's why eject is there, and yeah, it is quite useful. If you remember, also there were a couple of solutions to do that for the ADF files on Aminet. We have seen one of them on previous streams. Right now, it's in the operating system, which is much more convenient, and it works great. And what else? One last thing that I wanted to show you is that the list browser, which is this object here, this component, has right now ordering. So you can click at the top of at the title of each column and order the results based on that. And if you click once, it is incremental, and if you click it again, it will reverse the order. Quite useful if you want to sort things. For example, if you want to go, let's say, to here on residents and sort them based on the version, you can do that by clicking one time here on the first title, and it sorts everything based on the version. That's also a good change, because this is something that that you are going to have on your applications if you create something with if you create an application with using the reaction. So if someone develops a new application that uses these list browsers, he automatically gets that feature as well. He doesn't need to build it on his own. That's pretty much the updates, the changes that you can see on your new updated AmigaOS 3.2.1. Of course, there are a lot of changes, bug fixes that people reported to the development team of AmigaOS 3.2, and they created those fixes. I will say, read this change summary, because all the information about all these changes are here, and you can understand what changed better and have the ability to know that if that change influences you or not, if you need to make to change something on your hardware, and I mean on your drivers and things like that, not remove something from the hardware because of the update. So about the ROMs, as I told you, the developers recommend to not buy or create. If you have your own burner for ROMs, go ahead and create your own ROMs, or if you have a friend to do that for you. But they are recommending that you can use the ROMs with the Keychrom abilities of your hardware, if it has something like that, and you can load the Keychroms, the ROMs like that. Also, one more change that comes with these new ROMs is that if you don't have, for some reason, you don't have any device attached on your Amiga that the system can boot from, not any hard disk or floppy or whatever, the boot ROM image is going to flash red, so you are not you can understand that that's the reason that nothing is happening and that it doesn't find any device to use to boot from. Developer says, do we have to use Kick ROM? Can I just stay? You can stay with 3.2, absolutely. Yes. As you can see here, it is 3.2 ROM. I didn't use the updated one. I have a map ROM at Amiga 1200, but maybe I can erase and reprogram my 3000 or 4000 3.2 EEPROMs. If you have SLD Snake, something like that, if you have a burner for the ROMs, you can do that. Erase the previous ones and update them with a new one. If you use map ROM, then to load the newer ROM, then you might introduce on your system a second reboot of your when you first boot from cold boot. Okay, so if you don't want to have that, but you want to use the latest ROM, you have to create a new ROM 3.2.1. And if you have the hardware to burn your own ROMs, that's the best thing to do. But you can continue using the 3.2 ROMs just fine, without any issues. If I'm not wrong, if you use the 3.2 ROMs, the extra changes are loaded from the hard disk. That's the only thing. Otherwise, you don't have any problems. Anything else that you would like to ask about this update? The update process is quite straightforward. It's not a problem. There's no problems with that. So, and I don't think that, as you have seen, it is quite easy for anyone to do.